Please, Benedetta.
Hi. Hello, everybody. I am Benedetta Molinari, and I'm here to present you my innovative idea, which is about makeup. One of my, can you see that? Okay. Which is about makeup, as you probably guessed by this slide. And I'd like to create an innovative makeup store where you will find exactly what you need. And I call it B&M because where B stands for Benedetta, while M stands for makeup, of course. So let's get started with the presentation. I divided the presentation into three main parts. First of all, I'm going to talk about the problems that I meet when I have to buy makeup and that I like to solve once for all. Secondly, I like to show you my innovative idea. And I will explain to you what it is, how does it work, and so on. The third part will be about costs and revenues, because I made prevision about costs and revenues. Okay, so let's get started with the problems. In my opinion, there are too many shop assistants in a makeup store. And this could be annoying because they say something like they try to convince us to buy products we don't even need. In fact, when I enter, for example, in a makeup store in order to buy a mascara, I know that suddenly will appear a shop assistant and she or he will say something like, oh, you should try this because this color will look so good on you. So I think this is annoying and we need to eliminate this problem. The second problem is about tester makeup. In fact, when you have to buy, for example, a lipstick, you will need to try it on you in order to see if the color suits you. And to do this, you will need tester makeup. And I think that this is not hygienic at all.
Absolutely.
Because other people you don't know tried them before you did. So I think this is a problem. And then the last thing is about the choice of your foundation. I don't know if you are aware of what foundation is. I'm sorry guys for this, for this topic. And for example, when I have to buy a foundation, I ask myself, which shade should I pick, or which type of foundation will make my skin look absolutely flawless. And I, most of the times, I just pick one shade, then I go home, and I discover that it's too dark for me, like this girl probably did. So, moving on to the main part of my presentation, I'd like to create a makeup store, and in this makeup store you will find two or three shop assistants, no more, and then you will find some products on the shelves, but mostly you will find two or three rows of these smart mirrors. So what is a smart mirror? Let's have a closer look. As you can see, we have a mirror, but it is an interactive one. In fact, there is a touch screen on it, and you can click on these options. As you can see on the top of the mirror, there is a camera. In fact, this camera will allow the mirror to analyze and to scan your face in order to do some things. In order to do some things that I will explain later. So let's zoom in this part. Okay. As you can see, we have three options from which we can choose. For example, the first one is products. So if you want to buy a red lipstick, let's say this, you want to buy a red lipstick, but you want to try it before on you. So the only thing you will need to do is to go in front of the mirror, click on products, because it is a touch screen. So you click on it and you will have a list of products. Now you will need to click on lipstick, then you will have to choose the color. And this is this is what will happen.
This is a mirror, still, yeah, we're still dealing with,
yes,
a mirror.
Yes, it's a mirror,
okay.
Yes. This is how you will look in real life without any makeup on, but this is how you will look in the mirror with your red lipstick,
okay,
on. In
so
this
the
way,
mirror tells you, okay.
It tells you, it shows you how you look with a product without physically try that product. So I think that this is so effortless, so you don't have to do anything. And if you don't like the color, you can press back and you can choose another color. At the end of this, you can add it, you can add the lipstick to your basket, and then you can continue your shopping. Okay, as you can see, the second option is tailor-made foundation. This option will allow you to create your own customized foundation. In fact, the camera on the mirror will analyze your face in order to discover the tone and undertone of your skin, and you will be able to create your own foundation. So let's click on it, for example, let's see what happens. At first, you will need to choose the finish of your foundation according to your skin type. For example, if you have a dry skin, a very dry skin like I do, you will have to choose a dewy foundation, for example. On the contrary, if you have an oily skin or if you need a foundation in order to do a professional photo shooting, my advice is to choose this ultra matte foundation. So you have to click on this, on ultra matte foundation, and a screen like this will appear to you. This is you in the mirror, and this is
where
our...
did you take this photo? Is it a friend of yours, or you found
no,
it online?
I found it online on
okay.
Google. I googled it. I found that photo on Google.
Okay.
And the machine, the mirror, will suggest you a color, as you can see here. This
yeah.
is the shade that the foundation, the machine chose for you. But if you don't like it, because if you, for example, need a foundation, need to buy a foundation for the month of August, and you think that you will be tanned by the end of July, you can modify, you can change the shade right here with this wheel. You can, for example, choose another color, or you can make it darker, if you like, of course. And at the bottom of this screen, we have a box, and in this box, we have some tips, some foundation tips. In fact, the machine will give to you some tips for the application of your foundation. So, moving on, the third and the last option is tips. This option will allow you to have some advices for your makeup. If you, for example, have to marry, so you are the bride, and you don't know which highlight, you don't know which eyeshadow you should wear for this important occasion, you can click on tips, then on occasions, and you will have something like this. As you can see, we have a list of occasions, and you will have to click on wedding, and a video tutorial will appear on the screen. You will have this video, and you can watch it, of course. You can buy the products that this makeup artist used. In fact, on the right side of the video, we have a list of the products that she used, so you can purchase them if you like it, if you like them. You can click, for example, on a shadow, you can try it on, see if it suits, if it suits you, and so on. At the end of this shopping, you can end your shopping by clicking here on this chart.
We're still on the mirror.
Yeah, you're still,
still
in the mirror.
Interacting with the mirror.
Yes, we are interacting. These are all the options, and you can click on them like a touch screen, like a normal
yes.
touch screen, a common touch screen. So you can click there, and you will have the list of the products that you tried before. and you will need to finish your shopping. And the only thing you will have to do is to click on checkout. Then the mirror will print a receipt, and you will bring that receipt to the cash desk in order to pay your shopping. And at the end of this, you will have to leave your address, and someone will deliver the products directly to your home. Because, as I said before, we have a customized foundation, so we need to make the foundation, to create a foundation, and then someone will bring your products to your home. So this is the end of the presentation of the mirror on itself. And I made prevision about costs and revenues, and I put the data in a line graph. As you can see, on the x-axis we have the years, while on the y-axis we have the costs and the revenues. These in orange are the revenues, while these are the costs, and the costs in blue. At the beginning, the costs will be high due to the initial investment. In fact, we will need to buy the machine, the mirror. We will need to buy the software in it. We will need to buy the physical store, or anyway, we will have to rent it. And of course, we will need to consider the advertising costs. Revenues will come from the sales, so I hope that in 3 years we will be able to recover all the initial investment, and we will begin to make some profits. So this is the end of my presentation. I hope that you enjoy it, and if you have any question, please feel free to ask.
I have a question for you, but I want to see Salvatore asking a question first. Salvatore. Salvatore Federico. I have Monteres, ma Federico.
Okay, I will ask them. What kind of technologies do you use to create the mirror?
Okay, I think that I will hire some mechanical engineer to build this machine, because I don't think that I have the competencies to build the mirrors and to discover the technology in it. So I think that this will be my strategy. Mm-hmm.
To what extent do you really believe in this project?
Yes, I really do, because I like it so much, and I think that this could revolutionary the makeup world and the way we buy cosmetics, makeup, and so on. So I think that this could work.
So what's happening next?
Next to this?
Yeah, you have your idea. Mm-hmm. You created the presentation.
Okay.
You have I believe you have to finalize a few more things, and then what happens?
Okay.
If you want to
create,
to implement,
I don't know. We need to find some partner, for example. I will need to find the physical, the money in order to do this thing. Maybe we need to contact some banks.
Yeah.
And
having a patent. Do you
patent.
Think that it will be important?
Yes, obviously.
Yeah. Don't forget that there is a patent office here at the university.
Yes.
So you can go
I can go there and...
Yes. Because, it's a very nice idea.
I hope that...
What is your opinion, Federico?
I think it's a great idea. She could even sell this idea to a large brand like Kiko or... something like that.
Yeah,
as it's possible.
Uh-huh.
I hope that someday this could become a franchise
mm-hmm.
like Sephora or
mm-hmm.
like
mm-hmm.
Kiko,
mm-hmm.
and I hope that we can, that I will be able to do this.
As long as you don't wait for too long.
Yes.
Because as I told you in class that a couple of times it did happen to me, that I heard beautiful ideas, interesting ideas from students, and then they stop, they don't do anything about that. One is believe me, it was one student in business English that presented an idea, just it, and now other. And then I had another, it was another case. There was, and it was something
like
different, but it was called the magic mirror.
Ah, okay. Maybe it was something.
So don't waste your time. It was about clothing.
Okay,
it was about clothing. So don't waste your time with this
thank
idea.
You.
Thank you, Benedetta. Federico, it's your turn.
Okay. I will shut up.
Oh, you also have... Yeah, I told you to get ready with...